turn-based stuff, but it doesn't have like the raids. Like, I mean, it does. I mean, they both have different raids, and they're very similar games. ESO and 76. Like, see how the VATS is in real time, and you can see the monster move around down there, the opossum. That's evolved. That's 76. In any other game, the VATS freezes you because they're all offline. So this is the evolved one. If I had to recommend one, it would be this one. And but they're all there, and they're all cheap. They're all cheap to buy, I think, most of the time. You can get most of the Fallout games and get super absorbed forever for a long time. I play a lot of custom stuff, and my character is very old in the single player mode, so I tend to make this game look easy, but it's not really a very easy game. It'll often kick your fucking teeth in, not in its like execution, but it's combat. It'll kick your fucking teeth in sometimes. It'll just suddenly there'll be 18 fucking like scorched just suddenly flooding you, and it'll come on strong like that. There'll be 13 robots or whatever. Like, here's a bunch of farmhands, and suddenly it pops like, you know, a bunch of diamonds and
Mr. Farmhands are out of control. Evacuate civilians and take down those supervisors. Once they're dealt with, they'll have to move to the server.
It has a very Grand Theft Auto 5 execution in its mini games. Like, these are like little mini game events that are like public raids. So their damage is very high, and it's considered their damage when they blow up like that, and so it one-shot me. That's not that common, getting one-shot like that, though it does happen. It's an excellent aim trainer. And so I made it all one-shotty like that because I wanted one-shotty. The game is too... If my biggest complaint about the game is it like all of them, especially the older ones. This one's got it bad, but like they all have it. The mobs are bullet spongy. They will take a lot of hits. It doesn't matter what game you're playing. Starfield, you know, Skyrim, doesn't matter. Every mob in all these games are like, you know, fucking really bullet spongy. But custom's really fun. I like, you have to pay for the monthly to get the custom, but
message. The Forest Watch detects all supervisors down. Good job. Responder team, proceed to the Ag Center and get to the mainframe. You need to reset the farmhand targeting parameters.
So, the other aspect of it is it's a lot like New World, or...
That should keep our people safe in the area.
Like Minecraft, or... what's alert. Another good
possible
example?
Compostables detected. At all. Potential
What was I gonna say? So it's very strong game in the respect that once you buy 76, they're all like this, Fallout 3, Fallout 4, you have a game for life, which is why Bethesda is such a hot topic all the time. You could buy the entire Fallout series, I think, in a package, probably on, what am I thinking of, Humble? Humble Bundle might sell Fallout in a package for really cheap. You can probably get all of it. Let's see, Fallout, right? The whole Fallout, well, yeah. So for $160, which is a lot of money. Oh no, Vegas 76 is not included in this, which I guess is, I don't know why they would sell it without it, but it should. But you get an idea, like you could live for forever in the worlds of Fallout or Skyrim. But I mean, it's got its problems like every other game. It's not perfect. It's not worth playing them in order. It's worth playing them in like what you can stand, because they're so old and so janky that, like, you know, the older you get, the older the game is. Like Fallout 3 is the oldest one. The more janky as hell it is. So just understand, like, the, you know, composting target. I would say your best bet is 76. If not, stick to Fallout 4. I wouldn't worry about Fallout 3 or New Vegas. They're so old and so janky that if you like modern gaming at all, the graphics look old and janky. You know, like, you know, it's just kind of funny. They look clunky and boxy, kind of. Like this, like, see how this looks like a piece of crap, kind of, this soda machine? The whole game resonates with that. And so the older you get, the more janky and old and more annoying the experience is, kind of. The less forgiving the game is. Like, Fallout 3 was kind of an unforgiving game in the respect that, like, if you go up in the Super Duper Mart at the beginning of the game with 25 Scorched or whatever on you, you're gonna fucking die. Those guys are all gonna push you and just kill you. Unable to locate. Now, you might live if you're on, like, easy setting. But hard or higher, you're gonna get swarmed so bad you die, and the game can play like a survival game in the respect that you can't really move much faster in a Fallout game like 4 or 76 than you could in real life. So if in real life 12 zombies pushed you, you could probably, if you had guns, you could probably kill like 4 or 5 of them. But the other 7 are gonna fucking kill you. And so that's how Fallout plays. That's how Skyrim plays too. So it can be very difficult. It comes across as this see there's like 4 of them, which is significantly dangerous to me because I have high damage set. So if they hit me, I die. So gotta get out a faster weapon here and think about my loadout. There's 3 zombies in here, and if they all push me, I'll die. Yep. Gotta kill them. Yep. That's sort of like cheating. I could have cheated Vats on that and made it easier, but... Oh no! Get out, get out, get out! Get out! Ah! Fuck. What else is left in there? Is there more? Yep. In custom mode, the game looks a lot better. In the normal MMO, it's like, you know, kind of slower and far less fast paced, you know? I have a custom setting to make it appear more action-y and more fun. I don't understand why I'm stuck. Okay. There we go. Nothing at all. So it plays like it's ESO a lot. Like, ESO had dolmens and omens and stuff that you would go into, public dungeons and raids. This game's got that. Yes, When you made a baby, the day I felt better. When you made a baby, the day together. Be nice if you to wake up in the car to bed. Boy, their drummer wasn't so good. Talk about it. Without it. About it. Wouldn't it be nice? Nothing. They're all the same game. They're all the exact same game. From Fallout 3 to New Vegas to 4 to 76, they all play exactly like this. Hack the terminal. 76 tears me up because it's like, I love this game and I can spend a lot of time here, but it does not have a big following anymore. I mean, it has a big population, but it's only got 500 pop, like, watching. So, you know, that's kind of a problem. So I try to stay away from 76 at times or try to throw it in with other things because it's... no, I don't want to talk to you. A sleeper... No, bobby pins. Oh, I gotta buy bobby pins, damn it. It has endless content, but it also gets sort of repetitive. But I like the combat simulator of it. It never really ends, and you're always just sort of moving forward. It's good. It's got my favorite combat system of all MMORPGs, I would say. It's the most fluid and enjoyable. I don't want to talk to you, friend. Are you fixing to gank me? I think that's what you want me to think. No, I don't want to be a member of your corp. I don't want to be threatened by you or controlled or ganked or any of that stupid shit.
Well, you don't look too worse for wear. You managed to figure out where those miscreants are hiding? Fantastic. So that's where their boss will be. You just need to...
Wait, West Virginia lumber? That is not right. You misheard them for sure.
And that's of concern. Why, exactly?
Was wandering up that way not too far back. The lumber company? That place was overrun with a bunch of those big green bastards.
Mutants.
You've seen those Frankensteins. If this gang was able to clean those things out of the mill, Duchess, these guys might be tougher than advertised.
Hmm. You got any recommendations on how you'd proceed?
Kill them all.
Well, I wouldn't go in guns blazing, unless you got some big guns.
Oh, I'll take them.
Try and luck your way inside. Maybe
Steve-O
will talk to you. But there was this family I ran into up that way that I'm sure has had to deal with them already. There was also this
every time I hear his voice, I see his tattoo.
Who was making some pretty bold claims about his knowledge of the mill. Wouldn't be a bad idea to check in with either of them. You'll find them at Anchor Farm.
Anchor Farm.
But if they are still there, well, there's no skin off my cheek.
Wait, the scrapper.
Anything else you want? Found him. Guy kept... But, probably have a bit. Well, that's a good thing. If you haven't already, and take care of yourself.
Can't believe I died because of pickpockets. So fucking annoying. I would normally work on my hardcore character right now, but... Hardcore is not a good thing to work on in the background. Should technically run FFXI, I would say. Fallout 76 is kind of like my de facto replacement for Rust, and I'm not trying to play Rust right now as much as I can, you know. I'm hungry, huh? Oh, did I make another survival syringe? I did. Yeah. I recovered from parasites. Yay. Let's see. Oh, you know, I was going to make bulk stuff. Yeah. We'll make bulk stuff now. And sell it to her. Make some real money. Okay, so... where am I? I'm in port. Yeah. I need to go get Signet, and then I'll warp out of here. Just don't know where to go, kind of. I should go to... I want to go to Leetalore, but it kind of lags me, I think. Could go to Shock Rami? No, or not. I don't know. I think this is actually where you normally go to Crawler's Nest. So maybe I'll just walk out of here. Or, well, I'll take a Chocobo, I guess. Why does this game lag so much when other games are running? It sucks. See, look, this game does not run well when the other two are running. Damn it. I'm just gonna log out. That's fine. Does not play well with others.
The asteroid is depleted. Is depleted.
I have 3 levels? God damn. Can't believe I landed that. Good old Bethesda hitboxes. One of the reasons I like 76 is it keeps me in practice. I'm always taking shots at things and trying to aim better and get better, you know? It definitely provides targets all the time, which I do like. It's like a never-ending shooting gallery of just, you know... Never-ending shooting gallery of just, like, shots, and it helps keep me limber for games like Rust when I actually do need the shooter skills. These things hurt. I can't really fuck around with them like this. They'll kill me. Yeah, if I aggro, like, 7 of them, I'm dead. It'll be embarrassing, too. God damn it. Where are you, you stupid NPC? It has a Red Dead Revolver feel to it, definitely. Because of the VATS. Oh, God. Oh, grenade! Run! Oh, you fucking... Ouch! Oh! Fun as hell in custom mode. I like it a lot more in custom mode. A lot more fun. A lot more kind of, what's that one game? What was that? Where is he? Where is he? Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god. Okay, okay, sorry. Wait, short what? All the violence and the gore, that's all custom stuff. I love it. Can't get it in the vanilla game. You can get the violence, but you can't get the force most of the time unless you hit him with like a mini nuke or like a M79.
The asteroid is depleted.
Hell, we got a trespasser? here, huh?
Hey, everybody, welcome back to me. Welcome back to Fallout 76. Something that I'm going to check out. All right, guys, we're going to head down to the Garahan Mining Headquarters. Excavator armor.
We won't kill
you. And we've been up to this tower a couple of times, and somebody said, why don't you go check out the monorail. All right. Okay, so we're going to go. We're at the Garahan Mining Facility, and like I said, right here, just on the southeastern part of the ash heap right here. So, I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to slip over here.
I love Nuka Cherry. It actually really works.
And I'm going to go. We're going to go up this tower real quick. And we already have one of these. Our Monograd's got one of these. And she was going to give it to me so I could show it off. But if I could find one, then it, and she was going to, you know, so. Okay, so we're going to go, we're at the Garahan Mining Facility, and okay, right here, just on the southeastern part of the ash heap, right here.
What?
So go ahead, I'm going to step over here, it's the monorail system, and I'm going to go.
What's that sound?
Just on the southeastern part of the ash heap. On the southeastern part of the ash heap right here. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna slip over here. It's the monorail system. And I'm gonna go, we're gonna go up this tower real quick. And we already have one of these. Our Monograd's got one. And she was gonna give it to me so I could show
oh, it. That's what it, oh, that's what
I was one, then it's gonna make it even better. Go over here. Oh, wait, no, that's not it. I'm not high enough up. Oh, do I have to drop down again? No. No, I don't. Here we go. There's a ladder right here. Go up the ladder.
I'm going to use the Super MK2.
Go left.
With the serrated machete. I'm going to kill them all. And then loot it all later.
Walk this tightrope. Don't freaking die.
Got to check my stats before I clear this quest. Oh, I'm not rested at all. I have to get rested, son of a bitch.
Here we go. Alright.
No fucking way.
Here we go.
No fucking way.
Look at there! Look what we found! We found a fat man! Oh my god! This is a persistent spawn! Somebody said, go on the monorail and walk down it and you'll find a fat man. I was like, no. Persistent there! Walk this tightrope. Don't freaking die. Alright. Here we go. There's a ladder right here. Go up the ladder. Go over this way. Go left. Walk this. Walk this tightrope. Don't freaking die. Alright. Here we go. Here we go.
I've seen him before. I just don't know where to find one directly.
And look at there. Look what we found. We found it.
All right, so let's go do that, but not yet. There's a pipe rifle. Takes 38, it's a single fire. I don't know. It seems good, but it's Bestie is 12. Yeah, maybe it's fire as well. Maybe I should try it. Let's see. Pipe rifle. I can't remember how those work. Yeah, this is a really good weapon. This is the best weapon I've had so far. I was like, isn't the pipe rifle the good one? Yeah, but this will just wipe the floor with them easy. Because I have a boss fight here.
No one's heard from Batter.
Suspects he finally managed to get himself killed. Batter was a long shot anyway. Always figured it'd take someone
this thing's got a scope
full box of crayons to find us our prize.
Grenades! I mean, that's what a grenade would do. I mean, that's what it would do. I mean, that, you know? Yeah, they'd be dead. I like seeing all the stuff fly all over the room. All the buckets and everything. Bottles and bourbon and shit. You gotta, like, loot the floors carefully after you do something like this, because all kinds of stim packs and drugs can get dislodged and, like, fired around everywhere. You gotta be careful. Wait, that's an automatic pipe rifle? It is an automatic pipe rifle. Well, shit, that's even better. So, shit, make that. Okay, short automatic pipe rifle. Pipe rifle. And, yeah, we'll just use these until I get something better, you know? I'm not in love, but I wanna fuck you till something better comes along. I'm not in love, but I wanna fuck you till someone better comes along. Okay, we're done here, I think. Oh, leave the gang a message. Yeah, right. Where is that? That's like up, yeah, up here. Oh, no, no. Oh, yeah, right here. Yeah. Leave the wayward alone, or I'll nade your fucking boss. Hoping for some, like, booze and stuff. No bobby pins. Damn it. How have I not got any bobby pins? I just looted this whole fucking place. What? I thought it was an actual flamethrower. I was like, what? You got lockpicks. Okay, I'm done with this place, and now I want to go to his tip, which is like down here to Garham Mining Headquarters. Which might be kind of scary for me right now, but we'll see. I've got weapons, whatever. I got enough weapons to hold my own. That guy didn't seem to act like he had any combat, so we might be okay. It's a lot of loading screens like Starfield, but it's a lot better than Starfield. Like, a lot better. Ding! Okay, so we're going up that thing. Such cool thing. They do cool stuff like this. I love this shit. Guess not. Please don't fall. Nope.
And a fat man. Oh my god, this is a persistent spawn. Somebody said go on the monorail and walk down it and you'll find a fat man. I was like, no. No. Dude, this is...
Well, if it was, they removed it.
Really easy to get to. Just wanna follow where I'm going.
Fucking idiot.
Commands and missing persons. Also, there's an extra breeze, so find it on high level. This is the only guaranteed spawn that this weapon has. Also, there is no other way that you could obtain a physical copy of this weapon's plan. So there's a low chance that you could obtain it by completing the quests. Novice of the Mysteries, Supply Demands, and Missing Persons. Also, there's an extremely low chance that you can obtain it from doing dailies in the Cranberry Bog area. Now keep in mind, the chances of you obtaining it that way are extremely low. It's best...
Make your way up here, and the front door is right here. So you come through here.
West Tech.
Just a word of warning: there's a super mutant suicider. If you kill him non-lethally by not shooting his hand, you actually get a mini nuke, which is could be useful in the coming moments. Now, I don't even know if the Fat Man's here.
I haven't got it yet, so we'll soon find out. I did get a quest activation.
The Fat Man is. So that's my first. There you go.
Oh, but you can't even use it until 50 anyways or whatever. So, yeah, I didn't even think about that aspect of it. So that's okay. I'll just work with grenades. Grenades are fine. They were. I like them more than I used to. I'll get that grenade perk next. Or, well, if I can. Well, it was worth a little check, but I can't even use that item anyways, so... I got some good follows, yay!
The asteroid is depleted.
You're back. Well, that, though, Judge. But you did good. Maybe. But there are two of the. You track them. Music, missing person. Find them for me, and I'll appreciate it. Find out what.
Talk to the Grafton mayor, yeah, right. I love the explode on range attack perk. It's so strong and awesome like that. Just fuck shit up sometimes. So good. The game does not want for RPG thickness. It's got all that RPG goodliness in it. strong numbers and strong boosts and strong perks and strong crazy stuff like, oh, your bullets explode on impact into a, your, some of your bullets are actually grenades, and it's like insane. Not explosive rounds, grenades, you know. Suddenly one of your bullets has a grenade on impact. That's what just happened. Crappy ass SAR. At least it's automatic. SAR is not automatic. I just loot all this, like, basically, like, combine it all and then sell it in bulk to the vendor and try and get my daily caps. Buy syringes so I can live. Lockpicks.
Stimpak, I'm hurting here.
The asteroid is depleted.
Oh, thank God. So, much as I see the me and my buttercup, I heard some.
Someone there? I could use a lift. You are a sight for sore eye. So, those things didn't get you, huh? You happen to see a young man on your way through? Early 20s? Rough around the edges? He's a... What do you... You get me back? That? You... One bot built to kill.
Custom is where it's at. It's where the real fun of the game is. I don't know why, when the game's capable of being like this, why they made it all stupid and slow and annoying. I guess it's for like co-op play, so you have something to shoot. Everything's bullet spongy, but it's not that fun soloed unless it's like this. That was a good box. I had a lot of shit. But custom, I don't have to worry about weight all the time. It's so nice. I don't even have to build a base if I don't want to stop. I can just keep doing the content. Doesn't matter. You can ignore the survival side of it if you want. Which, frankly, if I want to survive, I play Rust. Like, on a populated server.
Damn. Ammo finally corroded. Wet Cave really did a number on it. I'm not going to be much help now.
That sucks. I really like that gun. Shit was vaporizing zombies pretty good. This is my favorite place in Fallout 76. When you get out of the Gully Mine. I don't know, maybe I want to turn the damage down a little bit so everything's like... Not exactly one shot, you know? Maybe I'll log here. And I'll change the settings so maybe my damage isn't so nuclear. Because it seems like a little cheaty a little bit. Let's see, view the world. damage. Let's try 200%, see if it feels better. Maybe I can go through the Gully Mine again. I don't know, does it respawn the world every single time? I think it does. You can get it to spawn monsters on top of you all the time, which is something I really value about it, but I don't know. You can't take breaks or anything. It's kind of annoying. You can't stop. You can't alt-tab or anything because you're always being attacked, which is kind of annoying. I wish it wasn't like that. God damn it. They like won't let...
Always wanted to retire in the forest somewhere.
Take it! Pull my...
Jesus Christ.
back at long last. But where's our girl?
Oh, God! Polly?
Whoa. You're not looking so great, darling.
Duchess, I'm not feeling great.
Frank, why don't you set a date? Jug should do the trick.
This is real snug.
That's not gonna...
Oh, Polly.
Solomon,
Did I?
Duchess?
It's all right. Oh.
Solomon. Look, I can...
Please?
You... Here.
And here. And me.
And at the risk...
Oh, I have to talk to her to buy lockpicks, damn it. I forgot. And sell her things. Alright, you. I have 347 caps. I need you to... Oh, good. More money.
Warp drive active.
Nice, I got a new med. So yeah, we're gonna use a lot of that. Beer, corn soup, food. All the rest of it I'll just sell her.
Docking permission requested.
Good. 374. Good.
Docking request.
I need lockpicks. Oh my god, you don't have them? Son of a bitch. Damn it. Well, okay. Soul's transmitter to a pristine body. Nice, I got a lot that time. Sweet. So now... Now we go to Flatwoods.
Warp drive active. Overseer's log, town of Flatwoods. My God, there's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations we expected. But there's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person, but it had the...
Are you here for the responder training? Then you're not alone. At first, I really enjoyed... Wait a minute. To be honest, the other... They also... Go right ahead. Me? But when I heard... I decided to stay here and... It's... That being... If I were... He's a close... I never got... Okay, what is it? I found it. I'd also... What they... Yeah, the Agricultural Research Center is infested with feral ghouls. The New River... No problem.
Hey, volunteer. If you need supplies, Bob's got you covered.
There, see, damage is better, but it's still not, like, they're not spongy, though. They're not, like, spongy. They take some hits, but they don't, they're, like, yeah, they don't get deleted in, like, every hit, you know? I love custom. It's one of my favorite fucking things of all time, really. It's where I should spend my time. It respects your time so much more.
Really nice before the war.
I want to build this character. I've already had a character, but I want to just start over again. I might just start over and over again until I finish the season.
Make yourself at home.
I did.
No, I know where Kesha McDermott is.
Automated warning to all responders. Mr. Farmhands are out of control. Evacuate civilians. And take down those supervisors. Once they're dealt with, you'll have to reboot the server. Again.
See, they're still too spongy. Like, they're still too spongy. Ouch. Well, I don't know. Maybe it's actually better. Mr. Farmhand. Oh. Run! Fucking missed him somehow. Ah! Can he even hit me now?
I know it.
What? Where are you, fuckhead? Oh, I see him now. This is way more fun. Custom. So fun to do the combat. Where are you?
Scanners
feels like a 3D version of Hotline Miami. I fucking loved it, and I loved this and missed it. I should have done this originally. I just started a new character, but like, I don't know. They didn't make it good until now. They're about to make Atlantic City like a zone that they're going to open up in a couple of weeks. It'll be so fun. A brand new area.
Biological material processing. Scanning for fertilizer. Alert. Possible source of compostables detected. Potential source found. Initialize scanning protocol. Error.
It's actually really fun.
Farming operations in progress.
Yeah, but I don't remember how I get down. There it is. Recipe for Psycho, nice.
Is depleted.
Now, if you've missed one from a past season, you can actually go buy some with gold from in-game vendors like Samuel over at Foundation. With all that being said though, let's take a look at each terminal option and how to unlock it, as well as what items you can actually get from having it active. Now, shout out to Miffy from the data mining Discord. This is all like information gathered from a list that they made, so big shout out to them. Link for it will be down in the description. Now the first terminal option we're going to talk about is scrap. This is a very basic one and will just provide you with any and all types of scrap that you can think of. Aluminium scrap, ballistic fiber, black titanium, anything you can think of, you can get it from this one. So it might be worth having if you want the chance of getting some ballistic fiber. Now, to unlock this one, you do have to have unlocked the Scavenger Collectron Station. This one, I believe, was a free item in the Atomic Shop and does come in. Now, the generic option is Junk, and this one doesn't actually require any specific Atomic Shop purchase or any specific unlock. This one is literally just included with all of them, and it includes just lots of random junk items. But we're talking adjustable wrenches, biometric scanners, blowtorches, bobby pins, chalk, cigarettes, any random thing you can think of, this thing can pick it up. So just think of every type of junk in the game, it's probably going to pick it up. Now the next one is something called a proletariat. Now I don't know what that actually means, but hey, oh, maybe I should have searched it for the video. Anyways, this one is unlockable via the Communist Collectron Station. This again is an Atomic Shop unlock. And this one provides you lots of random stuff, so you can get some junk from it, the ball peen hammer, but you can also get a lot of different soups as well, which are actually pretty good, because a lot of the soups available are actually buffs in the game, like Blight Soup, Brain Fungus Soup, and also Glowing Fungus Soup, as well as various other as well. Now following that, also unlockable from the Communist Collectron Station is the Revolutionary Option. This one includes lots of different weapons and also grenades and stuff as well, linking to that kind of revolutionary idea of this collector's going to find stuff to help you fight the revolution. So you can get submachine guns, Chinese officer sword, you can even get a handmade rifle in this one. So definitely some funky ones available, and it might just be worthwhile having this on for scrap purposes. Of course, weapons.
Wow.
For building up your steel and stuff like that. Now, unlockable with the Santatron Collectron Station, you can actually set up Xmas gifts. Now, the really cool idea of this is, when you actually have the Christmas-themed seasonal event on, you can go around, and if you've got, like, say, Fallout First, or even a public server, you can go take a load of workshops, place one of these down, or any Collectron with this setting on, set so it's got the Xmas gift, and basically, you can just go bouncing around all the workshops, and it'll just keep collecting the gifts for you. Important notice, you will only collect the gifts while the seasonal event is active, and other than the gifts, it does collect you a bunch of other random bits and bobs. You can get pre-war snacks like Dandy Boy apples, Fancy Lad snacks, you can also get a bunch of scrap items as well, like raw fertilizer, Mr. Fuddy's, Fuzzy Teddy's, boxing gloves, kind of all ones themed around the idea of Christmas. They would all be kind of like presents and stuff like that, like a rattle, a baseball, all this type of stuff. There's also a Fashnet collector on that came into the Atomic Shop. This obviously will come round the time of Fashnet, and maybe now and again on sale. And this one has the option of Fashnet Treats, which links with a bunch of different kind of consumable items, and also like just scrap items linking to the consumables, like wine bottles. So you can get beer, you can get bourbon, you can also get bourbon bottles, that type of thing. Very simple stuff. There's also linked on here that you can get Fashnet donuts and sausages. There is meant to be a bug. I don't know if it's been fixed, but according to this, there is a bug where you can't actually get them. Now, adding in with the Raider Collector Station, there is an option for chems and alcohol. This is the great one, really, to build up your caps and stuff, because obviously all the chems you can go sell. Or if you want to build up alcohol for dailies and weekly challenges, when you've got to consume alcohol, get yourself some score and other bits and bobs, then this one might be option for you. You can get anything from beer to berry mentats to grape mentats. You can get psycho buff. You can get all sorts of different stuff in this one. Also available with the Raider Collector Station, you can get ammo and weapons option. This one is literally is what it is. It says it on the tin. You get 308, 38, 44s, 45, 556, a bunch of different ammo, but sadly, according to this list, no energy. You can get ballistic, but also beautiful weapons like combat rifles, double barrel shotguns, lead pipes, other bits and bobs. Now with the Brotherhood of Steel Collector on station that came in, you can also get ammo through this one as well. It's very similar to the collector on station, the ammo and weapons option, but this one brings in some energy ammo as well, like a 2mm electromagnetic cartridge, you can get that. And you also get scrap mixed in with this, as well as some crispy things like cranberry meat. So lots and lots of that's actually one of the longest lists of items. You also get chems like Radaway stuff in there as well. So this one's kind of like an all-rounder. It's got ammo, it's got chems, it's got consumables. So
Reverend Delbert Winters here.
Now, with
born
the gold
and raised in
this
very
town.
Let my own church to the responders for their outpost here. And you're welcome. The responders are on a true mission, you see. Helping folks through thick and thin. Till the heavens open up again and take us all up anyways. When this all happened, I figured, like most, it was time. this was the end, but it wasn't, was it? We're still here. At first, I thought it was a mistake, that we was missed, forgotten. Maybe we did some wrongs. Didn't give enough to charity, maybe. Didn't praise his name, even in the worst of times. Maybe thought some things that ought not to have been thought. So I asked him. I asked how. Why? I fought your wars on Earth. I'm ready to fight them up there by your side. Then, in my despair, I saw some survivors eating raw red carcasses behind a dumpster. You ought to cook that first, I warned them. It seemed obvious. We tried, but got sick, they said, covered in their own filth. I realized right then and there that I was being tasked. From then on, I built kitchens, cooked good food, fed anyone who walked up with an empty belly. And I was thankful for my task in life. Thankful. Next time hell or high water land in my stoop, I'll be swept clear away with it. But until then, let's share a home-cooked meal together, all right?
Oh, I have a shotgun now. Starlight Berry Cobbler. That's good. That's the XP. Or no, that doesn't give XP. I thought it did, but it's the other one. Ribeye steak, that was pretty good. Go. Super Chem MK1. Check in with it. Okay. Look for Delbert Winters at his home. Okay. Nice, let's see what I can do. Yes, I would. Okay, we got Junk Shield, Iron Stomach, Slow Metabolizer, Hard Bargain. Let's go for Hard Bargain. Next level, I'll put another point in so I can get Lone Wanderer. I'll do Lone Wanderer next level, I forgot. Wait, did I get any other perk cards? No. Oh, I do have Dead Man Sprint Tinkle. And can do, or Junk Shield. Good, we can go to carry junk. Okay. Let's do a Junk Shield. Oh, no, level 10, okay. Looking for a weapon bench, but I don't think you have one, huh? There's a chemistry bench, but not a weapon bench, I don't think.
Asa asked me if I would talk about, how I got here. She asked everybody, so I said okay. My name's Colonel, and I'm 13 years old. I just wanted to say I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everything. The bombs and the messed up people and the cows with two heads, all of it. I was bad. Just bad. I cheated on my spelling test. I kicked Chip Wilkins in the shins until he cried. I pushed Rosie McCloy down the stairs. I cut holes in the bottom of all the gym shorts and put glue in the mashed potatoes in the cafeteria. I told Harold Newell to eat 10 dead flies a day in order to grow muscles, and I put Nuka-Cola in the rat cage water bottles at the pet store. And, I just wanted to say I'm sorry about everything. Because my dad said if I wasn't this way, the bad things wouldn't happen. I haven't seen Daddy since the bombs, and I guess he left because of that, too. It's okay. I'm trying to be good now, though. I'm not old enough to be a volunteer, but Dasa said I could help collect food and water, so I'm getting better, I promise. And, Daddy, if you're listening, I promise I won't be bad anymore, so you can come back now. Okay?
Seven AM, never tell the odds, so social camp items for building. Oh, crash. Oh, damn it. Well, maybe this is a good time to stop, I guess. It has been 11 hours and 55 minutes, and I believe I'm going to stop here. And I want to say thank you for hanging out with me today, and I'm sorry for all the anger today. I'm just going through some stuff, and that's all. And, got much better towards the end of it when I beat the stupid-ass quest, but that quest has fucking stolen so much of my time this year. I think the anger was righteous, and that's the problem. So, and I'm sorry for that, you know? Oh, absolutely, number two. Yeah, thank you for hanging out. And, so now we're going back to the station. Talk.
Warp drive active.
Okay. Just a reminder, guys, this whole session will be recorded and put on YouTube today. And thank you for bearing with me. I had a kind of a bad day today, and I apologize for that, but that's all right. I still got 12 hours of entertainment. And I'm going to bail out here at 12 hours. And thank you so much for the time, guys. I appreciate it. And I will see you tomorrow. Just a reminder, come to Skycat Live, skycat.live, and click on the cat's face to donate if you're on accent. YouTube. I'm not a member of, you can't sub to me on YouTube, so come and click on the cat's face to donate. And you can sub to me on Twitch if you'd like to. And I am an affiliate of Twitch. And thank you so much for your time. Thank you, number two, for hanging out with me. And you guys have a wonderful day. Take care. I love you. Bye.